wing, as it was known. These were heavily marketed by Ford.
Thank you. a little bit, and then I got by cracking Bill Dell.
And Henry Ford, he'd fallen out of love with David Brown and something like that, but that would have been used for ploughing, and tractors like that came over from America on the Liberty ships as car tractors that could produce in sufficient numbers. Its lineage goes back to 1917 with
these wood-burning kits to fuel the Fordson. It basically runs off the gas produced by the wood burning, and actually a useful byproduct on this facility that we have is charcoal. There we are.
So, Model N Fordson. The last were made in 1945, but it's one of the great, the interesting tractors. Seems to be going from strength to strength. Although most of them aren't as glamorous as some of the cars and the loads of long now. Now, Henry Coleman used to see in the countryside a load of cows out grazing, how tight is the chain. Very important to me, that's the celebration, this enduring movement, this great man, who's going to slow down the race.
Thank you. the bus that they're actually travelling on, and obviously the Bristol Mixed Bus Group, which has been helping out with our up-top rides around the airfields this weekend. Very grateful for the Bristol Mixed Bus Group for the loan of their vehicles. Right, the other vehicles we have, the middle Bedford CA in the middle of the arena. This is an example of a vehicle that you don't see much of these days, but nearly every country bus company had them to take people to skittle matches and things like that. And this one is one of very few that's actually survived. So it's nice to see it's come all the way from Aberystwyth to be with us this weekend. Following on, we have the first of a nice little lineup of Bedford OBs. Now, the collective noun for a Bedford OB is a whine. And that's from the noise the gearbox makes. There's a lorry coach. It's got the side windows. Following on, we have a slightly different one. This particular one, the bodywork's almost the same as the one in front, but the chassis was actually built in Cheltenham. It was actually an apprentice piece for an apprentice for Haynes and Strange, the Bedford dealer. They built it and put the body on. So it looks like a Bedford OB, but technically it's not. And we are behind that. Another lovely little Bedford. This one from Lewis's in Somerset. And on that, 1 metre race line. The little blue and grey one. Again, these ones haven't got the side windows, so the touring windows. Bedford's built over 12,000 of these, and there are only around about 75 in existence. So to have the selection you have here is quite phenomenal. Coming in behind, we have a bus version of the Bedford OB. Again, the bodywork's by Dupal of Hendon. And this particular one spent most of his life with Bristol Tramways at Western Supermare. But the type is very, very associated with the Stroud Valleys. So you may have seen those, you may remember from the old days in Stroud, he was going up the valleys. Following on, two OBs from your local coach company, Alex Cars, Cirencester. So these are probably the lowest mileage vehicles to get to the show. All of these little Bedford OBs are bodied by Dougal. The one on the left, as you look from the commentary box, was new to a company on the Isle of Wight, and they sold it to Alex Cars, the Cirencester. Alex Cars used it for several years and then sold it on, went through a couple of companies, then ended up in a scrapyard. The owner of Alex Cars wanted to preserve a Bedford OB, heard about this one, went to look at it as a restoration project, and discovered it was one of their old vehicles, so he had to buy it, and here it is now. And right in front of us now is a very important vehicle for us this weekend, AHU 803. It's Bristol J type, again belonging to the Bristol Vintage Bus Group. This used to belong to the Nailsworth Boys Club. A chance notice on Facebook asked for people who remember this bus to get in touch. I got in touch to say the bus still exists, if anybody's interested, and it will be at this show. And we've had a lot of interest. It's been on Points West, it's been on the radio. So I'm very pleased to see it here. It was built in 1934 as a petrol engine coach. It rebodied after the war as a bus in 1947, and is as you see it here now. Next to that is Daisy, Bristol L type, built in.
Bottle shops, so I can take it back in. Take them out, and you just point out for that.
What do you work on both of these buses, the Filton Bridge, Bristol?
I got on it and I'm sat at the front and I looked at the fuel gauge.
I was just looking to see
That was smart, yeah.
Yeah,
slip. Yeah, so you've still got the opportunity to use most of the other bits of equipment, and if you look at what's coming in and around the arena, you'll see farm trucks, tow trucks, little parabellas.
You have a thing called the trombone, which is a lever that you pull out. When you pull that out,
that's how I think.
Very useful feature, which was unique to both turbos. You fit it in on there, you have the torch rate.
Okay.